probably someone in your school with a dyslexia.
But do you know what it is?
Dyslexia affects reading, writing and spelling.
It can make it harder to learn how to read, write and spell.
But luckily, in Gentleshaw Primary School, we are dyslexia friendly.
But what does it mean?
Let's go and find out.
A policy tells you how to run a school.
We have great policies here to help all learners.
Let's find out how a policy is done.
Hello.
How do you know everyone is learning in your school?
Well, we have to make policies so that everybody follows the policy, and I do that with Mrs. Pinkham and the governors, and we look at different styles of learning for children, and we do that again with Mrs. Pinkham and the governors so that we can make sure that children learn in different ways but are given lots of opportunities to learn. And it's by having those policies that are make sure that children learn effectively.
How do you make sure teachers have the skills to support dyslexic learners?
Well, we have, of course, Mrs. Pinkham's excellent as her role as SENCO, and she manages to train all the teachers using the IDP plan. So we know all about dyslexic, we know about how children have signs of autism, and we know how we can help those children in their learning. And then some teachers will go on training, or Mrs. Pinkham might go on training, and then she'd come back and tell us all about it. And also by walking around the classrooms, we can see what's going on in school. And we can also talk to the children to see the type of things that they like using. Like, they love using the VAC boxes, which are good for everybody, but particularly those children with dyslexia. So we're very, very lucky that we've got such a good SENCO that does our, make sure that we're all up to date with everything that we should know about.
How do you make these policies happen in school?
Well, we have to check, don't we? And like teachers check on children doing their work, I have to check that the teachers are doing their jobs. So I make sure that they're following the policies, and we have teachers watching lessons, like I might watch a lesson, or Mrs. Pinkham might watch a lesson, and we talk to the children to see that they know what they're doing. And all of that helps me see that what we're supposed to be doing in school is being done.
How do you make sure the governors know about policy in our school?
Well, I take the policies to the governors, and we look at them, and they agree with the policies, or they question it if they want to know anything further. And Mrs. Pinkham, as SENCO, she'll make sure that the governors have a termly newsletter about what's going on, so they always know and are up to date with what we do in school.
Where can these policies be found?
Well, they can be found in my office in a folder, or on our website, our school website, and in some cases Mrs. Pinkham will have some of the policies that she needs in her folders. But anybody can see them on the website, or most importantly, anybody can come in and have a look at them in our folders.
Mrs. Pinkham is the school SENCO.
She makes sure all children learn in school. How do you make sure children with dyslexia are spotted?
Well, because I'm the SENCO at Gentleshaw Primary School, I have to make sure that I train all the teachers to spot dyslexia. So we have something called an IDP, which stands for Inclusion Development Plan, which means everybody has to be able to learn in the classrooms. So I train the teachers at staff meetings about dyslexia. We use Brian as well to help that. And I give them checklists that they can then check against children's learning styles and different things that they do in the classroom. And then that might give you an indication if they have dyslexia or if they have another learning need, which might be dyscalculia or autism or a behaviour need.
How does the Inclusion Development Plan help you teach in your classroom?
Well, it helps me to understand dyslexia and it also gives me lots of different ideas. I'm from Mrs. Pinkham on how to support children with dyslexia and how to support all learners in my classroom.
Right, we have lots of assessments in school which are really important to help children identify their needs. Okay. Now, first of all, we have our profile books that we do three times, once in the autumn, once in the spring, once in the summer term. And basically, with our core subjects of maths, English and science, we have targets that are outlined, class targets and individual targets, and the children feedback on how well that they feel that they've achieved those targets. Now, to help reinforce those targets, we look into our normal books here where we have objectives, and that informs the child what they're going to be doing for that lesson. And then at the end, teacher feedback to see if they've actually achieved that target. And normally they'll get a tick or a reward or a written target to say where they need to go next in their learning to help build their confidence. So next time we do the next piece of work, they can put those things into place. And on top of that, to help with the writing, then we have our spelling tests that we have systematically. We have them once a week in class as well. We can get certain phonetic sounds, letter blends, and we have three groups also, so that helps with the children to make sure that the spellings are set at their appropriate learning level. Children that need extra support from children that are identifying with dyslexic and autistic traits and dyscalculia traits. The children have what's called an IEP, and on the IEP they have targets that they've got to work towards with the teacher and with the teaching assistant. And we can write down in a lot more detail what the types of support that we can offer the children. And generally it's important confidence building, small intervention groups, like the RM maps, the toe-by-toe phonic groups that the children in this class work with Mrs. Mosley to help them bring on the work for English and maths. And on top of that, all of the children are given a screening process to see how well they're doing in their English and their numeracy. So we have something called a dyslexia screener, where the children sit on a computerised programme and it highlights information that would be for me as the teacher to help guide them into their support areas. For example, if a child is below average with the spelling skills, I'll look at what type of problems that the child's got, what weaknesses, and I'll try and work on those with the child to help them improve. And we also have a similar one for dyscalculia, which is to help support the numeracy skills. So again, that will tell me exactly how well they've coped with different areas of maths. And the areas that are lower down on the scale, that's what I'll target and give the appropriate support to the children. So there's lots of assessments, as you can see, going on in our class, just to help make sure that the children are progressing well, but also having fun, because that's what it's all about.
We have the dyslexia screener and the dyscalculia screener, which we do at the start of every year for every child in the school. And we also, in our SEM folder, we have a dyslexia checklist, which we can fill out if we are concerned about a child in our class.
All dyslexia-friendly resources have a paw print or a sticker on them.
Let's go around school and find some dyslexia-friendly resources. school, we have water bottles to keep our brains healthy.
In this school, we have a phonics reading scheme. This helps us to read in school.
Want to show us a book off there? What's that up there, Jack?
It's a timetable.
And what does that tell us?
What we're doing today.
So what did we do this morning then up there? Can you explain?
Writing.
Yeah, and what was the other one for?
Maths.
And do you do that every day?
Yes.
Does the timetable help you know what's happening in the day?
Yeah.
What's the door for, Matilda?
It tells you what we're doing today.
And is that helpful?
These are Brian's board that helps us to learn.
You can see all the learning family, especially Brian's.
Yep. Who can use this board? Who can look at it?
Teachers can look at this board to use it for information for dyslexia children. This reminds us we have lots of different learners in school.
How do you share targets with parents?
We have profile books where assessed work is sent home and their parents can see the targets in there, the children share them. And then we also have something called IEPs where the children make their own targets up and they're shared with parents as well.
How do you know if special targets are literacy?
I have an IEP and it sets me my targets down.
This is my profile book and where's it? And these are the happy, sad, or cross faces, or feeling faces.
And do they tell you how you feel in school?
Yeah.
And what happens if you had a sad face on there? What would happen?
You would colour it blue.
But who would help you? What happens if you had a sad face?
The teacher would sort you out.
The teacher would sort out what it was that was making you sad?
Yeah.
So is that a good way then to help you if you're worried about something?
Yeah.
What special things do you have in the classroom that help you learn?
We have a special backpack that helps teachers and children learn.
What does VAC mean?
It means you learn with your eyes, ears and body.
We get to have Brian if we've done good writing or reading.
And do you like having Brian?
Yeah.
We have a backpack in every class so it can help us at our learning. The timetable CD to help us with our timetable. Harry Hedgehog helps us with our sentences. Highlight important words. V Cup Pimmeridge. Pinch or grip to help you with your handwriting. This is a fiddler. This is the reading ruler to help us read the words.
Waving your banner all over the land. breath ready.
I'm doing my handwriting in the sand. Every day to help me learn my maths.
And what have you been learning on that one? Half.
Half.
And you have to go around the racetrack.
Do halves.
Yeah.
And you've got to write them down as fast as you can.
And does it help practicing every day?
Yes.
Do you get better?
Yeah.
What are you doing, girls? Smart shoes. And what's that helping you with? What are you
knowing
learning?
What grammar.
What? Is it fun?
Yeah.
Yes. Girls?
What's the point?
And what's this helping you with?
Maths.
Is it decimals and percentages?
Yeah.
Is it a good way to learn your maths using games?
Yes. Yeah.
Is it fun?
Yes.
What are you doing?
Maths bingo.
And how is it helping you with your maths?
It's got like 3 times 3, and if he picks up, like, this is 6,
yeah.
2 and 3, then I just got 9 because it's 3 times 3 and I said I got it first.
And is that a fun way of doing your maths?
Yes.
I
tried to slow down three.
Good girl.
And Nessie, tell me how it works. What do you have to do?
You have to do little games to get nuggets to go in the theatre to spin.
And do you enjoy it?
Yeah.
And how often do you go on it? Do you go on it every week?
I think, yeah.
Yeah, you do? Oh, every day?
Yeah, every other day.
Every other day. Oh. What are you playing, Charlie?
Nessie.
And do you like Nessie? And what does Nessie do? How does it help
you?
With your spellings. Have you got better since you've been playing on Nessie? And do you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
What are you doing, Nicholas?
Doing my RN to help me learn my maths.
Do you enjoy it?
Yes.
10 times 10 challenge. Are you ready, Myla? Nice and loud. Chloe? Is it fun?
Yeah.
Do you like it, Grace? And does it help you learn your phonics and reading?
It does to me as well.
Oh, good.
How do you know that our people work at schools? What might I say to all of the other children?
present to give you.
Fantastic.
You show Mrs. Pinson what that looks like.
Fantastic.
What else more? What do you get, Ted? What do you like to have on your jumpers?
One. Let me find one.
You've done good work. Me and you do lots together when you've done good work.
I say
a high five.
I have done super learning this week.
Have you, Tyler?
Yes.
And have you, Ben?
Yeah.
And have you, Lydia?
Yeah.
And what do we do to celebrate, Lizzie?
We do a song.
What's it feel like to be a superhero, Grace? Do you like being a superhero, Tyler?
Yeah.
Are you proud?
Yeah.
How do you feel, Ben?
Really happy.
And how do you feel, Lydia?
Happy.
Who wants to be a superhero this week?
Some children get stickers for doing good work.
We have stickers because we've got good scientists.
You were good scientists. Yeah. How does that make you feel, Myla, that you had a sticker today?
Happy.
And how do you feel, Olivia?
Happy.
Happy. What will you do your stickers now you've got them?
I'll put them in our book bags.
And what will you do, Olivia?
I'll put them on the back of my drawer.
I've got these stickers for doing good work and spellings.
And how does it make you feel when you have a sticker?
Really happy and really happy. Badges on my times table, badges for passing my times table in a minute.
Can we have a look at it? And which times table did you have to do?
Three.
And how did you feel when you got your badge?
Really happy.
Tilt, can you tell us how do you know that Class 4 has been a good class?
Mr. Evans normally writes in a book if we've been good or not, and he normally gives us house points.
How is your screen for showing you that it's good? What's it got on it, maybe?
It's dog.
Okay, can you show it up? Hold it up to show Mrs. Pinkin.
Right.
Class 2, how do you know if you've done good work?
Well words.
Yeah.
Extenders. And punctuation.
And how do you know you've done well with that, Ben Carter?
Because we highlight it.
Do you always highlight it, or does your teacher highlight it sometimes?
Sometimes we highlight it, and sometimes our teacher highlights it.
You know you've done good work because you get stars and the wish.
Right. And what are the stars for?
The stars are for good work.
And what's the wish for?
The wish is for what you need to do.
Reese, what have you got good work in? Which book?
Maths.
And how do you know that that's good work? What have you got?
A green light.
Yeah, a green light.
And a superstar.
And how does that make you feel when you get those in your work?
Happy.
We collect our stars at the front of our book.
And what do these pictures remind you of?
Of targets.
Well done. And who's he?
Harry Hedgehog.
And what does he remind you of?
Full stop, make sense, capital letters and finger spaces.
And which body part shows you capital letters? Point to them.
The eyes.
And full stop is?
Nose.
Make sense is?
Mouth.
And finger spaces is?
Hair.
And does it help you remember, Myla?
Yeah. I know I've done good sentences because I've got a Harry Hedgehog and some stars.
And what does Harry Hedgehog stand for then?
The hair is finger spaces, the eyes are capital letters, the nose is a full stop, and the mouth is make sense. My yellow star is for well words. My green is for Harry Hedgehog sentences. My purple is for my pink is for good starters, and my purple is for beginning, middle and end.
This is my literacy book.
And how do you know you've done good work?
How do I know I have done good work? 2 stars and a wish.
And what do the 2 stars say? Are they good things or bad things? Are they good things or bad things?
Good things.
And what's the wish?
A target.
A target. And what's your target? To use connectives. Okay.
This is my new book, and we get 2 stars and a wish, and the wish is for what we need to do better, and the 2 stars and 2 stars is for what we've done good.
How do you know you've done good work in your book?
Well, our teacher writes about how we've done good, our targets, and if we need to use capital letters and things like that. She also highlights in green the good sentences with wow words in.
And is that something that you can see straight away?
Yes, because it's bright green.
Brian's blog is sent to parents and governors every term.
To turn about learning in school.
Brian and all his learning friends have a website for you to have a look at home. And Brian has his own Twitter for daily tips for learning. We are the Dyslexia Friendly Ambassadors.
We are also known as the Brian's Buddies.
We help to make the school dyslexia friendly.
All ambassadors wear a badge.
What is your job in school?
We are the Dyslexia Friendly Ambassadors.
What is your job as a Dyslexia Friendly Ambassador?
We have meetings every term and we have to check the classrooms are dyslexia friendly.
How do you help the children understand dyslexia?
We have assemblies and we tell them about these different learning styles.
We also have Brian the dog who has dyslexia.
Do you like being a dyslexia friendly buddy?
Yes, because we can help all children learn.
All dyslexia friendly resources have a paw print or a sticker on them.
And point to it.
On each jammy there, there's Jamie on the one.
And what?
People.
And what does he have? What does he have, Patrick?
He has dyslexia.
And is he very successful?
Yes.
Is he very famous?
Yes.
So did he let dyslexia beat him?
No.
Guard your door. We've got Ronald Dahl. And who's this one on here in class 3?
We got no one.
Albert and stuff.
And he's very famous what?
He's a very famous scientist.
And what did he have?
He had dyslexia, but he didn't let it beat him.
How do you find out what's going on in school and what your child's learning?
The school keeper's updated with their internet website. Also, we get a newsletter from the class, and often we're also invited into the classrooms to get involved with what they're doing, and they can show us their games through games and their classwork.
Okay.
If you were worried about your child, what could you do?
There's a few things that I'd probably do. One, I could write in Carmen's diary so that the teacher could get back to me, or I'd come in and speak directly to Mrs. Winson or Mrs. Pimcombe, because she's the Senko coordinator.
How has Gentleshaw helped your child with dyslexia?
Well, they've got Brian's Buddy, which Conwin really likes, and it shows an interest, and she finds it better learning. Also, we've had someone in from outside the school to come and assess Conwin and to give her new targets to help her learn. And they also use special learning methods with her, and she has different things to help her on the internet with her reading and maths.
Do you feel you can suggest targets to Kynwin?
Yes, but mostly the teachers all come up with targets for us, and then if I'm happy with them, we set those targets and go ahead with them. But if I feel there's anything else to add, then I will speak to the teacher.
I hope you have enjoyed our video.
And we hope you now know how to be dyslexia friendly.
Thank you for watching.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. And the world, I'm turning inside out. I'm floating around in ecstasy. So
don't stop.
Having a good time, I'm a shooting star, leaping.